Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com. And as you can probably guess by that chord progression at the start of this video, today we're going to be looking at some John Mayer style guitar playing. We're going to be focusing on learning the guitar riff from the intro of the track Slow Dancing in a Burning Room. So the tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my early 1980s Talkeye Strat. Any Strat or John Mayer related guitar will get you in that tonal ballpark. I'm using a combination of the neck and the middle single coil for this, with the tone controls rolled off just slightly. There is a lot of debate online whether John recorded this track with just the middle pickup. It's totally subjective and down to what makes this feel right for you, so you can either use just the middle single coil or the go-to Mayer sound, which is the middle and the neck on at the same time. The amp I'm using today is the Blackstar Studio 10 6R6, which as you're hearing is completely clean. I'm using a real spring reverb with this. You can use a digital spring reverb or any other reverb. The original version of this track does have quite a bit of reverb added, so a real spring will definitely get you the closest. And the amp is running through the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X today, directly into my DAW. This riff is actually in the key of E major, even though the track has a very minor feel. That's because the lead chord for this is a C sharp minor. Now, C sharp minor is the relative minor key of E major. So you could view this as being C sharp minor if that makes it easier to visualize the positioning. And we're also going to be leading with a C sharp chord shape, like I mentioned. So here's the riff in full, and then we'll break it down. So the first thing you may notice there is I'm not actually using a pick for this, I'm using my fingers. This is a very touch sensitive riff and it uses a lot of control to get the tone right. If you play this with a pick, it's a little bit too bright. You can get the notes right, but it doesn't quite have the tone. When you play it with your fingers, the tone is a little more rounded and softer. And it allows you to really dig into the subtleties of this riff. So what we're basically doing here is we're outlining three main chords. So that's going to be a C sharp minor chord, but we're going to be playing it with our thumb over the top like this. Then we're sort of hinting at an A chord, and then we're hinting at an E major chord, but in the form of the C chord from the Cage system. But it's basically C sharp minor, A, E. That's the chord progression we're working with here. But we're doing this in a John Mayer style, so we're sort of alluding to the chord changes by playing around them. So the opening phrase you're hearing starts on the 9th fret of the A string, and it slides to the 11, and then we're playing the 9 on the G. Then we're using our thumb to play the low C sharp here on the 9th fret of the E. The next thing we're going to do is a percussive hit. So with our picking hand, we're going to be hitting the strings. So the reverb is what gives that note its slap. You can really hear the reverb sort of tailing off there. The next part of the riff is a series of descending dyads. These are found in the C sharp natural minor scale or the E major scale, depending on which way you're looking at the key of this piece. These dyads are all within the scale and they're going to be like this. So I'm playing the first one at the 11th fret of the D and the 9th on the G. The next one is going to be the 9 on the D and the 8th on the G. So those are on the same strings. Then we're coming to the A and D strings and we're playing the 11th fret on both strings and then the 9th. So those dyads are part of the C sharp minor chord. The next thing we're going to do now is highlight the A chord, but we're going to be playing it like this. So what I'm doing there is playing the 5th fret on the low E string, which is my A note. I'm playing that with my thumb. And then I'm playing the 4th on the G with my index finger and the 5th on the B with my middle finger. I'm playing those three notes together. I'm hammering on to the sixth fret of the G there. So what I'm doing in theory terms is I'm playing an A sus2 chord, and I'm hammering onto this note, which is the major note, the major third, and I'm turning this into an A major. Then I'm removing that sixth fret note, and I'm playing just the fourth on the G and the fifth on the B. The final chord I need to outline in this first pass through of the riff is the E chord. So I mentioned to you that it was going to be the E from a C form of the cage system. So we're not doing the full version of this, we're doing a triad version of this. So we're already in this position here from our A chord, or our A sus2. What we're going to do is this sixth fret note we've taken off, we're going to add this onto the sixth fret of the D string. So I'm playing six on the D, four on the G, five on the B. That's an E major triad, but I'm also adding in the low open E. So from the A, it goes. So that's the first pass through of the riff. So here's the first half in full. The second half of the riff is very similar to the first, but there's a slight difference at the start and a slight difference at the end. So we've already ended up on this E major triad with the low E string. So from here, we're not actually going to go back to the A string and slide up. We're actually going to do it from this point here. So I'm actually going to slide up this time to the 11th fret on the D string, but I'm going to repeat the first phrase of the song. The only difference here now is I'm not playing the note on the A, I'm playing it on the D. You'll notice that was exactly the same, except for the string that I slid on. So at the start of the song, it was on the A. But in the second repeat, because I'm on this E major chord, I'm sliding from here. So it's just up to the 11 of the D this time. But we still play the 9 on the G, and we still add the root here on the 9 of the E. Still got that descending dyad run, but then we do have a slight change when we come to frame the A and the E chords. So this time we're doing this. So this time I'm playing the fifth on the low E with my thumb. I'm barring the fourth on the D and G with my index finger. And I'm playing those three strings together. So the low E, the D and the G. But then I'm hammering onto the six of the D. Playing a double stop then on the fourth of the D and G. And the E chord I'm playing is once again from the C form, but this time it's the A, D, and G strings. So it's going to be 7 on the A, 6 on the D, 4 on the G, with the low open E string. So here's the second half of that slowly. After that last E chord, there is one more percussive hit, as you saw on that repeat. So here's the whole riff from start to finish, played slow. Now once more at full speed. So there you go, there is the intro riff for the John Mayer track, Slow Dancing in a Burning Room. If you want to see the tabs for this, scroll down to the description. There's a blog over on the PMT website where you can check out all the tabs for this riff and learn it for yourself. If there are any other famous riffs or licks you'd like to see us break down in these videos, put those down below in the comments as well. Let us know what you guys want to learn in these videos. Don't forget to check out all the other lesson content over on the PMTVUK channel. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher, please head to musicteacher.com. Check out the network of great teachers all around the UK waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.